The next morning Vandiyathevan was on his way to the city of Kudanta along with Ariza Langkare along with the First Minister Anuruddhar. He kept his horse steady and looked at the pleasant scenes on both sides. At the beginning of the month of Apasi, Cholawala Nadu was in full splendor. The Queen of Nature was dressed in a green belt and looked youthfully beautiful. How many different shades of green are there in that green bark? A semblance of rice crops ready to be sown in the fields. Young crops that have been planted for some time are another example, the green and golden crops that had been planted then were a different color. The leaves that flourished on the banyan tree were a green, the leaves shaken on the royal tree are another kind of green, the lush green of the lotus leaves in the lagoons, spectacular green of banana leaves, the ivory green of coconuts, the green of young grass on earth, the green of clear water in streams, greenery of frogs frolicking in the water. To show off the beauty of the various shades of green, the vases, kumudas and red lotus flowers were shining like star studs. Vandiyadeva took in all this beauty with both his eyes and traveled. He had felt the difference between the scenes he had seen when he had passed that way last month and the scenes he was seeing now. In the month of August, the river was bursting with new floods and foaming. Now the speed and fury of Prabhaga had subsided, and Bhavani had turned ruddy, clear as marble, and gaiety. The sound of the ho of the new flood and the rustling of the upper wind as it struck the branches of the trees, and the tumultuous tones of a thousand specks were then heard like the clamor of a great festival. At that time there was some kind of unknown sadness in Vandiyadeva's heart. The reason for this is not clear even after thinking about it. Indeed he had reason to be immensely excited. In this way, what Manaraj had done when he went 2 months ago has been fulfilled. Things happened that he never dreamed would happen. Sundara Chola visited Emperor Tanjavur, Palayere, Matadam, Anuradhapuram and other great cities have been seen. Pani, who was the eye of Kolanad, has got the friendship of Selvan, the valiant prince has found help, one must have done a lot of penance just to see Aralingamari Kundave, the goddess of beauty of Tamil Nadu and the lamp of the Chola family. How blessed is it to receive the love of her pure heart. His heart swelled with pride when he thought of it. But along with that exultation came some pain. Do I really deserve such a great privilege? Will it last? Shouldn't there be so many hurdles before the reach is reached? I must stand against their purpose and win. Is this possible? That Brahmaraya did not know what he really thought in his mind. Could it be that his intention was to separate me from the princess? Both of them said that all Arcadian will come and join. We will see him until now. That valiant Vaishnava, whatever he may be, has never done me any harm so far, he has helped many times. If you travel with him, he will be talking about something exciting. There will be no fatigue on the journey. Where else can he come and join us? How long does it take for him to drag this horse and make him go? Is this possible? That Brahmaraya did not know what he really thought in his mind. Could it be that his intention was to separate me from the princess? Both of them said that all Arcadian will come and join. We will see him until now. That valiant Vaishnava, whatever he may be, has never done me any harm so far, he has helped many times. If you travel with him, he will be talking about something exciting. There will be no fatigue on the journey. Where else can he come and join us? How long does it take for him to drag this horse and make him go? Is this possible? That Brahmaraya did not know what he really thought in his mind. Could it be that his intention was to separate me from the princess? Both of them said that all Arcadian will come and join. We will see him until now. That valiant Vaishnava, whatever he may be, has never done me any harm so far, he has helped many times. If you travel with him, he will be talking about something exciting. There will be no fatigue on the journey. Where else can he come and join us? How long does it take for him to drag this horse and make him go? Could it be that his intention was to separate me from the princess? Both of them said that all Arcadian will come and join. We will see him until now. That valiant Vaishnava, whatever he may be, has never done me any harm so far, he has helped many times. If you travel with him, he will be talking about something exciting. There will be no fatigue on the journey. Where else can he come and join us? How long does it take for him to drag this horse and make him go? Could it be that his intention was to separate me from the princess? Both of them said that Alwarkadian will come and join. We will see him until now. That valiant Vaishnava, whatever he may be, has never done me any harm so far, he has helped many times. If you travel with him, he will be talking about something exciting. There will be no fatigue on the journey. Where else can he come and join us? How long does it take for him to drag this horse and make him go? There will be no fatigue on the journey. Where else can he come and join us? How long does it take for him to drag this horse and make him go? There will be no fatigue on the journey. Where else can he come and join us? How long does it take for him to drag this horse and make him go? Aha! There are trees in a gang. Those roots lying like crocodiles in the flood of the river. This is where the film thrown on the toy crocodile took place. Varanai and Tarika, Sentru, and Mandakini laughed merrily at our heroic deed. It is in this place that the princess interceded for us and blessed those women. Let's stop here and see. Vandiyathevan got down from his horse and stood beside the river bank. He stared for a while at the clear stream that swirled around the roots of the tree. Aha! A face appears in that vortex. Whose face is that? Do you want to say? The joy of King Kundave Prati is golden. Hearing the voice that sang, Vandiyathevan was startled and looked up. Alwarkadian was seen sitting on one of the topmost branches of a noble tree. Oh! Veera Vaishnava! Am I so sweet to your piercing eyes? I can see you a little better. Come down! Vandiyathevan said. Veera Vaishnava, as he came down from the tree, I did not tell you, father. Do you look terrible to my eyes, with a sword in your clothes and a quiver in your hand? He said. Then, of whom did you speak, Vaishnava? When the Supreme Lord Thirumal took Vamanavathara and raised 1 foot to measure the sky, to the eyes of your Lord Shiva. Vaishnava. Stop. Stop demeaning Shiva like this. Otherwise you will be in great danger. What danger, father? Who can do me when the Lord has the chakra to kill the crocodile and protect the elephant? I've said what I say. Then it's your choice. Tell me what danger comes to me, brother. Didn't the people come to the gate of the palace in an uproar in Pahayere? Then I heard some Kalamugars talking. What did they talk about? The growing number of Veera Vaishnavas in the Chola country were told to sacrifice their skulls to Mahakali, pile up their skulls, stand on top of them and perform the Ananda Thandavam. Alwarkadian touched his skull and said, it is solid. It can withstand the passage of time. According to what I have heard, all the way I come today, Kalamukkas are wandering around bearing skulls and maces. Changing this front Kudumi garb to say, you are Shiva. No way, Dad, no way. What can't? I can't say that name if you say it. Saying Vishnuva, even if I change my clothes, I will change it. Look. A palanquin was passing on the riverside road at that time. It turned out that there was a woman inside. But I don't know who it is. Someone has to be a woman for the royal family, who would it be? Besides the dental carers, a nurse was walking by. Maybe the princess. It cannot be so. Vaishnava. Do you know who is on that palak? Vandiyathevan asked. Brother. Listen to me. Don't meddle in things that don't concern you. You've had enough trouble for that already. Many people will go by the wayside, what about that? Mount your horse, knock. He said. Oko. Is that Samasara? Veera Vaishnavar seems to have become a big zealot now. Have you forgotten what happened at Viranarayanapuram? Didn't you tell me to add a straw to the woman who went to Mudupalak there? That's an old story. Why are you taking it now? Let me go if I go. They said you will join me on the way. I have brought the horse Mela Mela all this time for you. Are you going to come with me again, or not?
You are going on horseback.
I am coming on foot.
How can we travel together?
You go to Kaila Takarai.
I will join you there tomorrow morning.
Vandiyadeva was convinced that all were Katayan was engaged in some other secret work and would not come with him.
Well, as you wish.
Saying that, he jumped on the horse.
He looked in the direction he had to go.
He saw black clouds gathering at the base of the northeast direction.
Vaishnava.
Will it rain today?
He asked.
Father.
What augury do I know?
Is not Apasi born?
Even if it rains, it will rain.
Get rid of the horse as soon as possible.
Look for some inn to stay the night.
All were Katayan said.
Vandiyadeva knocked the horse like that.
What divination do I know?
What all were Katayan asked was etched in his mind.
From this came the memory of the child astrologer.
The soothsayer's house is on the way, what if I miss him?
Who is going to get this fortune among those who aspire to climb the Chola Lion?
Didn't the child astrologer say that Ponniyin Selvan is equal to Dhruva Nakshatra?
He refuses to devote his mind to ruling the kingdom.
How easily did he reject Sri Lankan throne and Manimakudam?
The soothsayer's prediction that many continents will befall him has come true to some extent.
Similarly, will it work that he will get Makanadam in the future?
How can that be possible?
How far will my life dreams come true?
Can I get back the lost kingdom of my forefathers?
How far will I accomplish what I have now set out for?
Can Aditha Karikalar and Nandini achieve anything by standing across them?
So far we have survived two or three times getting stuck with Nandini.
Can it be done again?
When he thought of the young queen of Palvur, Vandiyadeva felt a horror in his mind.
It is true that she spoke to him with great love and respect.
But he could not know her heart.
She seemed to be leaving him for some important matter.
That is why she has been so patient with Vandiyathevan.
What would that matter?
Vandiyadeva's horse overtook the palanquin which had just passed that way.
This time he didn't even want to collide with Palak.
Palaku did not want to confront him.
But when the horse crossed the palanquin, the curtain of the palanquin parted slightly.
He came to know that the woman sitting inside was Vanathi, the princess of Kajambalur.
He thought for a moment whether to stop the horse.
Then he changed it and went up.
I remembered what younger Brady had said about Vanathi.
Where did the princess of Kajambalur go alone in this time surrounded by dangers on all sides?
Not even proper security?
He also saw another strange thing.
From a distance, two menacing-looking Kalamukha Saivas were staring at Vanati's palanquin.
Why do they look like that?
Who are the two of them?
Are they not the ones who came and talked to Arikandra when he was lying on the bank of the river?
It is true that Vandiyadeva did not have much sympathy with Vanati.
He thought that Vanati wanted to usurp the place Pungujali should have in Pani's heart.
He was angry with her because of this.
But he could not forget that the younger Brady loved her unconditionally.
So if any danger befalls Vanati, the younger Brady will suffer immeasurably.
But why risk it?
Don't meddle in irrelevant matters, mind your own business.
Alvar Kadian's advice was reasonable, but the scene of the two Kalamugars watching Vanati's visit from a hidden place kept coming back to his mind.
Here comes the house of the child fortune teller.
Let's ask him for everything.
Added.
That matter has not reached the brain for so long.
It seems that goddess Vanati also comes to the home of the child soothsayer.
The fruit slipped and fell into the milk.
We might as well take care of our business before Vanati arrives.
Thinking thus, Vandiyadeva stopped his horse at the door of the soothsayer's house and entered the small house.